इंग्लिश आती है, फ्रेंच आती है, जर्मन।
हेलो गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल। सो टूडे आई एम गोना शेयर विद यू द फाइव बेस्ट प्लेसेस टू विजिट इन जिनीवा इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर अ डे ट्रिप और इवन इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर मोर देन अ डे। आई थिंक दीज आर द फाइव प्लेसेस यू शुड नॉट वॉन्ट टू मिस। So let's start with some basic things about Geneva. So Geneva is the city in the country Switzerland, and it is the second most popular city of Switzerland after Zurich, and it is situated at the western part of Switzerland where it shares the border with France, and it is situated at the southwestern end of the Lake Geneva where the Rhine River exits the Lake Geneva, and the official language of Geneva is French. And it is believed that every other person speaks another language from the country, which is Italian, German or Romansh. And it is also believed that the quarter of the population of Geneva, or either you can say that the quarter of the population of the Switzerland speaks English, or at least they know English. And this is it for the general things about the city. And we went there by a rented car from Paris. So it took us around 6 hours to reach to Geneva from Paris. So now let's start with the five best places you should visit in Geneva. And these all are going to be the touristy places, because when you're visiting for the first time, you're gonna see all the touristy places. So let's start with the number one. So number one has to be Jet d'Eau. So Jet d'Eau is a French word which literally translates into water jet in English, and which is a huge fountain on the Lake Geneva, and which is also one of the biggest fountain in the world. And it is the city's most famous landmark, and I think it is visible throughout the city, and even from the air if you go up till around 10 kilometers. Yeah, you can check in by going 10 kilometers up to the... So originally in 1886, they built the fountain to control and release the excess pressure from the hydraulic plant, but later it became a famous landmark. So they relocated it and amplified it to make it this big Jet d'Eau. And the height of the water jet is believed to be 140 meters, and the pump rate is around 500 liters per second, which is good. And it's actually a good treat to your eyes. And if you're going in the summer, you can actually walk nearby the jet and get the bristles from the jet. And yeah, if you go nearby to the jet, like nearby to the pump from where the jet starts, you can see the little rainbows crossing, like little small rainbows. They are pretty. So you can wear your rain jacket and go there and get wet.
So now I'm in front of the Jet d'Eau, and there you can see we have all the brands of watches.
तो रुको जरा,
खींच लगाओ, ओए खींच लगाओ,
इनको खाना देना पड़ेगा, कुछ हमारे पास है नहीं।
अरे वो ना खींच लगाओ भाई, बस अब।
अरे आ रहा है, आ रहा है। शू स्वान कम, इंग्लिश आती है, फ्रेंच आती है, जर्मन? हेलो, अपने आप को खा क्यों रहे हो? तुम्हें खाना नहीं मिला? अच्छा साफ कर रहे हो? ओ डे, इतना लेट कौन बात करता है, बेवकूफ।
So number two is Jardin d'Anglais, which literally means the English garden, which is an urban park in Geneva. And this was the city's first park to be composed in the English style, which you can see from the typical curved English paths, which was further enlarged and modified over the years. In 1955, the place was decorated with a flowered clock, and which became the most photographed monuments of Geneva. So the garden is a home for a several hundred year old trees such as ginkgo, magnolia, sequoia, and a lot of tulip trees also. And the most surprising part is that the entire garden is managed ecologically and without any chemicals, and the 1,000 plants or the species in the flower clock is also managed in a natural way, which is extremely surprising. So let's move to the number three, which is Patek Philippe Museum. And as all of you might have known, or at least many of you know, that the Patek Philippe is a watch company or a luxury watch brand, which I didn't know before going there. So the Patek Philippe Museum is the museum about watchmaking and watches. How surprising. Which was founded in 1839 by the management of Patek Philippe company, obviously. And it is around 180 years old. And the museum was one of the best museum I have seen of this kind, which I think I'm gonna say it for every other museum. No, but I think this was surprisingly good because I was not expecting it to be as good or as much informative or this big, because the museum was of average size, but everything there was so miniature. So if you want to see everything, you're going to take a lot of time. And one thing that I want to mention, if you want to go and see this museum, please take like around 3 to 4 hours just for this museum, because otherwise you won't be able to see it completely and then you'll end up regretting like I did. And because I was left with like around 1 hour and I had to rush and then I could not see it properly. So please take a good amount of time for this museum. So the museum has 4 floors which were divided by their sections, and then you enter from the ground floor. There you have the reception and the office, and along with it you have a area where they showed all of the tools used by the watchmaker. And then you move to the first floor, which is the exclusive floor for the Patek Philippe collection from 1839 to 1989, and there they showed all kind of watches made by Patek Philippe, from pocket watches, sundials, the normal watches and the complications. And then you move to the second floor, which have all of the watches collection from 16th century to the 19th century, all of the luxury watches, the normal watches, which also shows you like how this culture of luxury watches started in Switzerland from the snuff boxes till the 19th century. And then finally you move to the third floor, which is the library, which has around over 4,000 work or publication just about watchmaking. And they also had those miniature books, like I don't know how to read them. And that is it for the Patek Philippe Museum. If I have to recommend only one thing to visit in Geneva, I think that is going to be this museum. So yeah, so let's move to the number 4, which is the broken chair. So as the name suggested, it's going to be a chair with a broken leg. But it's not a normal chair with a broken leg. It's a giant chair with a giant broken leg. It's a giant chair with 13 meters of height. So this broken chair stands across the Place des Nations, which is the home of the UN office at Geneva. So this chair symbolizes the opposition of landmines and cluster bombs and acts as a reminder to the politicians and the people who are visiting to Geneva. And I really like the sight of the chair, because when you go to the chair, if you look from the back, then you have a good view of the UN office, and then in front of that you have a broken chair. So it has a good symbolic representation to me. So finally, at number 5 is the Reformation Wall and the Parc des Bastions. So the Reformation Wall is inside the Parc des Bastions. So first we're going to talk about the Reformation Wall. So the wall portrays the major figure of Reformation in the form of huge statues. At the center, there are 4 outstanding figures of Protestant Reform Movement, and at the sides are those who spread the Reformation throughout the Europe. And the motto of the Geneva was engraved in those wall, which literally means in English, after darkness, light. And the Parc des Bastions is one of the most beautiful green space at the center of the Geneva, and it is a great place for the picnic, and you can play a lot of games there, including the giant chess, which was very much fascinating for me, but it was extremely crowded, so we couldn't play. People were doing their dance rehearsals there, kids were playing, and people were playing sports, and you have a restaurant also there, an open restaurant. And so all in all, the vibe of the park was really good. And I think that is it for the 5 best places you should visit in Geneva. And according to me, if you want me to rank those places, I think for the number 1 is going to be Patek Philippe Museum. Then number 2 will be Jet d'Eau. Third one would be Broken Chair. Fourth one is going to be the Reformation Wall, maybe because of the Parc More. And the 5th one would be Jardin Anglais. So that is it for the video, and if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment down below. And if you like this video, like, share and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching. Bye bye. People say that I'm on my way. People say I should stay that way. People say people say that before it's gone.